Hey guys, it's Huffy. I'm back again and I am going to do a nail video or a nail polish video today in November. From the 1st of November to the 26th of November, I was involved with a challenge on Instagram that was run by Polish Pony and Clare Gray. I will leave their Instagrams linked down below and Clare's YouTube. Polish Pony used to make YouTube videos. She doesn't really anymore. She tends to just stick to Instagram. The challenge was the November ABC challenge. We did one of these the year before as well, I believe. Basically, you go through your collection and you, for each of those days, you pick a nail polish that starts with the letter of the alphabet that corresponds with the number of the day. So A is 1, B is 2, etc, etc. Now obviously some nail polishes, some letters of the alphabet are harder than others, and we were going for nail polish names, not nail polish brands, if at all possible. And some of us tried to just pick untried, like me, untried nail polishes. And I have a lot of untried nail polish. Some of it has been like swatched on sticks, but never actually worn on my nails. So basically I tried to stick to polishes that were new to my collection and probably hadn't been worn or had only maybe been worn once. And I pretty much got all untried except for, I think it was one or two of them were not untried, but all the rest of them were ones that were basically new, which means there was a lot of indies in this, because they're the majority of nail polishes that I've bought recently. So I am going to go through them in alphabetical order. And show you and insert the picture that I put on Instagram. My Instagram is always linked down below. So, of course, I haven't checked to make sure these are in order, so I have to find the first one, which is, you know, I could be slightly more organized, but then that wouldn't be fun. Okay, so the first one I wore is Chichi's Aqua Chrome from Aqua Hologram, sorry, from their Hologram line. These are amazing holographic nail polishes. If you can get your hands on these, I managed to pick up the whole of this line because I got it on sale. They're all gorgeous. So this is Aqua Hologram. The second polish I wore is from Moonshine Manny. It's But I Said My Bad, which is from the Good Place collection, which I have all of, and you will see several more from that collection in this video. This is a green with gold and greenish flakies. I'm pretty sure it's got holographic in it as well. Yeah, it's a really interesting polish. And yeah. So this is But I Said My Bad. Next we have a polish from Pretty Serious, which was part of my more recent Pretty Serious haul when they re-established themselves. This is Karina, which is a purple holographic with a lot of silver in it as well. Really beautiful polish. So this is Karina. D is also from Pretty Serious. This is Dorado, which is from the same collection as Karina. And this is an orange holographic with orange and silver in it as well, I believe. Sometimes I'm not very good at describing these things. But this is Dorado. E is also from Pretty Serious. This is Emma Louise. This is a fairly deep base, but it has purple, green, and silver. The purple and green are slightly bigger. It is really, really pretty. It's a very cute polish. So this is Emma Louise. For F, we have another Moonshine Manny. This is Forking Shirt Bolts, which is also from the Good Place collection. This is my first white crelly. I have not owned a white crelly like this before. It is really interesting. It has matte neon glitters in it. Yeah, really interesting polish. So this is Forking Shirt Bolts. Next, we have another pretty serious polish. This is Grim Demise, which is a green glitter, or green shimmer. It's a micro glitter, so it could almost be a shimmer, but it's more of a glitter. Yeah, it's a really interesting sort of almost tealy, emeraldy kind of green. It's really pretty. Grim Demise. The next one is from Sinful Colors. This is actually new to my collection. This is called Hollowback. It's a silver holographic. If you know me, you know I like silver holographics. This is more of a topper, although I did wear it as a full mani. You probably want to sponge it to get better coverage, which I didn't do. I just think I put three coats on. But it's still fun even if you don't use it as a topper, but it would be a great holographic topper. And of course, Simple Colors is not that expensive. So this is Hollowback. For I, we have I Just Ethicized You in the Face from Moonshine Manny, another from the Good Place collection. This is a really interesting nail polish and very surprising. It's a duochrome, like a green to almost maroon duochrome. With silver flakies in it, but it's also holographic, and you don't really notice the holographic until you're out in the sunshine, and it's like really surprising, and you're just like, wow. There is another polish that's from the same collection, I believe, which is very similar, but it's a different colorway, and it's stunning as well, but this one really surprised me. Like, I didn't really notice the holographic until I was sitting in the car, and then it was like, holy cow, and I was just like sitting there staring at my fingernails. Yeah. So this is I Just Ethicized You in the Face. For J, we have Juniper from Zoya. This was sent to me by Omnia. It's new in my collection. It's a pixie dust, which means it's a textured polish. It's actually duochrome. It's a purple to green, but it's kind of hard to see unless you're like really looking at it. And it's got silver glitter in it. It's gorgeous. Yeah, so this is a Juniper. K is from OPI. This is a liquid sand called Kiss Me at Midnight. This is new to my collection. Got it in one of the buys that I did. It's another textured polish. I love textured polish. It's blue with silver glitters in it. So yeah, this is Kiss Me at Midnight. For L, we have Lyra, or Lyra, depends on how you want to say it. I say Lyra. This is from Pretty Serious. I believe this is from the same collection as Dorado and Karina. It is pink, and it has holographic and silver glitter, and it is gorgeous. So that is Lyra. For M, we have My Darling Clementine, which is from Pretty Serious. This is a orange metallic. It is stunning, absolutely stunning. I love a good orange. This one is a good orange. I'm pretty sure this has some neon in it because it's super duper bright. Yeah, I really liked this one. This is My Darling Clementine. For N, we have another Pretty Serious nail polish. This is Nightopia. This is a green metallic with a gold shimmer in it. Really interesting nail polish, great colour. So this is Nightopia. For O, I had to go into collections, like, almost all of those ones have not even been swatched on swatch sticks yet, I don't think. Maybe Juniper has, but all the rest of them I'm pretty sure I haven't even put them on swatch sticks yet, so they're that untried. This one has been on a swatch stick and have worn it, but only once. This is Orchid Amethyst from Sally Hansen from the Colour Therapy line. It's a really interesting purple polish with a shift to it. It's got sort of a fairly strong pinky kind of shift to it, which is kind of hard to see. My lighting's not good for this. But it is a really pretty polish, and it was my O, so this is Orchid Amethyst. For P, we have another pretty serious. This is Purple Monkey Dishwasher, which I've wanted ever since I saw that they'd made it, and never got around to buying it, but I did this time. And it is a purple glitter, shimmer. It has micro shimmers in it. It is stunning. It's bright purple. Purple Monkey Dishwasher is a saying that was used quite common in a group that I used to be in when you didn't have an answer or you didn't want to answer the question. You would just say Purple Monkey Dishwasher instead. So, I really wanted this polish. So for P, I wore Purple Monkey Dishwasher. So we come to Q, which is one of the hardest letters in the alphabet to actually get a nail polish for. I do have Quicksand from Sally Hansen, but I wore that last year, and it's pretty much the only Q in my collection, and I was like, pff. And I happened to be looking on Priceline, and I found out that there are a couple of Qs that you can get, and one of them comes from Rimmel, and it's called Queen of Tarts, and it's a bright red, and it is a really good nail polish. It's basically a one coat red nail polish, almost exactly like the Lancôme nail polish that I shared with you a little while ago. Just absolutely perfect, and it's cheap, and I got it on sale. So this is Queen of Tarts. Next, we have from Moonshine Maddie for our Ride or Die Protocol, another one from the Good Place collection. This is an interesting polish. It's kind of a rose gold kind of shade, lots of micro shimmer in there, really pretty. I think there's some flakies in there as well. But it's different. It's not like any of the other ones in the collection. It's kind of just one colour rather than multiple colours. So this is a Ride or Die Protocol. For S, we have Serpens from Pretty Serious. This is a fairly bright green with gold shimmer and a gold sort of flash and some green shimmer in it as well. Super pretty, and I think that's got some holographic in it, and I'm pretty sure it's from the same collection as Lyra, Dorado, and Karina. So this is Serpens. For T, we have from OPI Top the Package with a bow spelt B-E-A-U. This is quite an interesting nail polish. It's got a fairly deep base with a kind of bronzy type shimmer in it, or flaky. I'm pretty sure they're actually flakies, which is super unusual for a mainstream brand to use flakies rather than glitter. But it's really interesting, pretty nice on the nails. So this is Top the Package with a bow. For you, we have from Essence's Cosmic Lights line, Up in the Sky. This is a grey holographic with a fair amount of glitter in it. It's actually pretty nice, and it's almost a black holographic, but not quite. It's just grey, but it's still different to the other one, which we're coming up in, which is the next one. The next one after. It's after, which is more silver. As you can see, it's quite a bit darker. So this is Up in the Sky from Essence. For V, we have Vega from Zoya, which is another pixie dust. This has holographic silver glitters in it. It has kind of like a greeny kind of base. It does need like 3 coats to build up. The base is quite light, quite transparent. Even though it's sort of green, it's doesn't cover very well. So you're basically using the glitters to cover. So it ends up kind of chunky on the nails. But still, it's a textured polish, and I like textured polish, and it's got silver holographic in it, so it's right up my alley. So this is Zoya's Vega. For W, we're almost there. We have Welcome to the Universe from Essence's Cosmic Lights. It's a silver holographic. Silver metallic nail polish with silver holographic. It's, I was always going to buy this one. It's pretty. It's, this is Welcome to the Universe. For X, which is another letter that is really, really hard. Last year, I think I used XOXO, which is from Ultra 3, which is just like a goldy glitter toppery type thing. Almost like a nude glitter. It's kind of a bit dull, and I didn't really have any others. I didn't buy any for this one. This one is one that I've worn before. I've had it for a while. This is Xmas Red, and no, it's not red, written Christmas Red. It's literally written Xmas Red, so it fits. And it's just basically a bright red glitter. It's a 1 coat red glitter though. You don't need 2 coats with this. 1 is enough. It's packed full, but it's also not like super thick. I don't know how they manage that. This is from B Nails, which is the salon brand of the salon supply store that I buy most of my acrylics from. This is a Christmas red, or Xmas red, for those who don't like it when people use that word for Christmas. Left. And the second to last one is my absolute favourite from the month, and it is probably my absolute favourite polish of the year. That video will be coming up soon too. There was a collab for the top polishes for 2019. I will be doing a video. This one, fair warning, this will probably be the number one. This is from Moonshine Manny. This is called Ya Basic. Again, from the Good Place collection. I think I have the whole Good Place collection in this video. This is a purple to greeny, like foresty green, almost teal. Multi-chrome, duochrome type of nail polish, but it is also a linear holographic, which is like my total jam. And I didn't realise it was linear holographic until I saw it in bright light. And then I was like, holy cow, this is almost my perfect polish. It's not quite teal enough, sorry Phoebe. I like it a bit more teal in the shift and a bit more purple. It's kind of like a reddy purple. I want more purple, but it is a purple to teal holographic, linear holographic, and it's beautiful, stunning on the nails, really hard to photograph, but absolutely stunning on the nails. There's actually a video of it on my Instagram. But yeah, this is Ya Basic from Moonshine Money. And last but not least is actually a mainstream polish. This came in my collection, I think, from an Oz sale or something. This is Zip Me Up from Essie. This is their like gel couture type of line. This is a mint green with a shimmer. you can't really see the shimmer in the bottle. It's only when you put it on your nail. Interesting nail polish. Don't have anything quite like this in my collection. But yeah, really pale minty green with a shimmer. Really pretty, and a good way to finish out the November ABC Challenge. Yeah, so this is Zip Me Up. So that is it for this video. Make sure you check out the ladies that are linked down below. They're both great naily people if you're into nail type stuff. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have and you want to subscribe, click the button down there. Click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like nail type videos. And leave me a comment down below. I will like your comment, and if you ask me a question, I will try to answer it. And I will see you in my next video. See ya.